All right, welcome back. This is Pano again. I'm back with my next video series, and this is the seventh video of the series of how to solve design aptitude, nonverbal, and ability questions. And in this video, I will be covering this particular set of questions, which I will be flashing in a minute, so that you will decide whether to go ahead watching this video or not, because some of you might not want some of these to be covered. So I will just flash the questions. So the first question will be on something on pull list, identifying some, there's some question here, so we'll check that. The second is on again on ability question of identifying the missing pattern here. The third is on something on routing. Routing, if a person start from some particular position or start point, where will he reach? That is the kind of question. And the other one is on something again on ability question of what will be the pattern, missing pattern here. Next question is on something related to physics, and the question is, I suppose, is on finding the volume of water after some operation. So we'll check that. And the other question is something similar to this is these are all ability questions. Same here. It is on which of the options will work. That's the question. And this is a tessellation kind of question where if you unfold this particular solid, which options will suit the given configuration? That's the question. So we will try to discuss in detail about this. And here is the, I think this is the final question. Yeah, final question on given these particular dimensions, and if I turn this pedal to some degree or some turns, how far the vehicle, I mean the bicycle, will move? So that's the question. So these are the questions that I am going to focus in this video, and I hope some of these are interesting to you. And as usual, I am expecting that you are safe, happy, and you are doing great in your preparation as well as at your studies. So that's it. Let's start with the first question. Okay, I have already copied here. So the question says, shown below is a combination of where is my cursor? Yep. So the question says, shown below is a combination of fixed pulleys. Yeah. If the triangular load moves down between this triangular load, if we pull it down, how many pulleys will rotate? Sorry, how many pulleys will rotate in the same direction as the smallest pulley, including itself? The overlapping paths do not interfere with each other. Okay, so the question says, if you pull this down, this weight. So the smallest pulley here is this, according to me. So let me highlight that. So they're saying, whatever the direction this pulley will rotate, so like that, in the same direction, how many pulleys are going to rotate? That's the question. So in my previous video, I have touched this something related to pulleys. I have told that if there are set of pulleys something like this, and if say if the rope is going like this, or let me take different color here for easy explanation. Consider this as rope. Okay, so if I'm pulling this here, so what happens, the rope here, let's say if I take points along these ropes here, 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 and here, so the point here will try to move up, right? So because this is being pulled, the point here is going to pull down, right? So exactly the opposite of what is here. So because this is being pulled down, so the point here is going to be pulled up, right? Let's say these are the centers. And because the rope here is going up, the rope in this direction should go down, right? So I hope you got this simple fundamental, right? So because I'm pulling here up, the ropes in alternatives, like in the next one, it will in the opposite direction. In the next, this is opposite to this one, and this one is opposite to this one. and we can easily identify the rotations, I mean the turn of this pulleys. Like if the rope is moving in this direction, which means the pulley should move in this direction, right? So if the rope is coming down, here it is going up, which means the pulley should go in this direction, right? So likewise, if the rope is going up here, so which means the pulley here is should also turn in this direction, right? So that's a basic, that's a very, let's say, let me call it as fundamental. Okay, using this fundamental, let us try to, identify all the directions, all the movements of the rope as an exercise. If not from exam point of view, from learning point of view. So let me zoom in. Okay, let me start. So basically what we need to do is we need to start from where the load is happening and go in the reverse direction of how the flow is happening. Okay, so if let me take 2 points here. Okay, let me take some points so that it will be easy for explanation. This is just for explanation, right? The points I'm taking. By the way, the points here, by points I mean the points on the rope, any position on the rope. Okay, it's coming here. Let's take here. Take here. You can see how I am moving in the reverse direction, I mean along the rope. Okay. Here, and it will go here. Here, this one, let's say it is coming here. Let me take this. Too many pulleys, right? Okay, it's going here. Here. It also goes. Okay. And finally here. Okay, so it's also obvious that I should mention here, so the whatever rope you're, how much the whatever length rope you're pulling, let's say if you pull say 2 centimeter of rope here, so here the the drop of the, I mean the lowering of the this point is going to be also 2 centimeter. And here the movement in the upward direction is going to be 2 centimeter, which means finally this point is going to lower 2 centimeter only, because the rope length, we are not changing the rope length, right? It is being fixed. So whatever length you are pulling up is going to affect here. So same as this is just for your understanding. So likewise, how much length this is going down will make this counterweight move of the same length. So that's what you need to understand. If this is x, this is going to be x, right? So that's a simple one. So let us start, go back. So since I'm pulling this down, so this point is going down, right? Since this point is going down, so this point is also going to the left side, which means, so this is going this direction. So obviously this pulley is rotating like this, right? So now you should understand why I have drawn this. During exam, it is not required for you to draw like this. Simply, you can. I will tell her that how you can do that. Right now, from explanation point of view, I will tell the actual basic thing required. So since this is being pulled to the left, so this point will also be pulled to the left, which means here the rope should come this way. So which means the pulley should rotate like this, right? So since this is being pulled like this, which means this point is actually going up, right? So since this point is going up, the point here is being pulled towards this direction, which means the this small pulley is going in this direction, okay? Which is nothing but the clockwise direction, clockwise, okay? Now since this is being pulled here in this direction, so the point here will also be pulled in this direction. So whatever the rope here is going to be pulled in this way. Okay, got it? And same way the red, the green rope here, because this is being pulled from this direction, Point here is going to move in this direction, and because the rope here is moving, being pulled here, so this pulley, the rope over this pulley is actually going to turn like this. Basically, I'm just following the arrow. See, the arrow here is in this direction, so it is the head of this is going to follow the tail of this. You can remember that. For example, this is the tail, so the next one should follow the head. So head is this way. So head is this way, following the tail. So this is the tail. So tail is following the head. So like that, you can have a short understanding. So see, this is the tail. So since this is being pulled here, so the rope will be going up here. Likewise, the rope will be going up here. Since the rope is going here, the pulley has to be turned in this direction. Okay, and since this is moving in this direction, so here also it is moving in this direction. So which means the rope here is actually pulled in this direction, right? So which means the rope here is actually pulled down. Only then it is able to do this operation, and because this is in direction, so the rope at the point here will also have will move down, right? So that head is following the tail, that's what you can say. And since this is going in this direction, which means the rope here will pull the pulley in this direction, right? So here the rope is moving in this direction, which is coming here, which means the point here is going to be pulled to the left, right? Since the point is being pulled to the left, which means the rope, the pulley on the rope is actually moving in this clockwise direction. And since this is clockwise, the point here is actually pulled up, so which means this rope is actually going up, right? And since this is being pulled up, the pulley is actually moving in this direction, right? And likewise, since this is being pulled from this direction, this point is actually going to move in this direction. Same with this. And since this point is moving in this direction, which means this pulley is actually moving in this direction. You're getting me, right? Okay. So also, since this is moving in this direction, this point is going up. Okay. So this, since this point is going up, so this pulley is actually trying to turn in this direction, which is clockwise again. So since this is turning clockwise, the point here is pulled to the left, right? And which is same, which will happen with this point also, pulled to the left. Okay, we can pull here. And since this is coming from here, so which means the point, any point here will be pulled to this direction, right? And since this is connected to this point, which is actually moving in this direction, so here this point is actually, you know, moving to the right. So since this is connected here, so this pulley is going to be in this direction. Okay, and since this is being pulled, so the point here will be pulled here, which means the whole thing will move in this direction. Because of this pull and it is connected here, so the whole pulley is going to rotate in this direction, right? And since this is being pulled up, which means the point here is actually going up. So I will draw here, the point here is actually going up. And since this point is going up, which means the rope here is actually trying to turn in this direction, which is counterclockwise, anticlockwise, right? Since this is being pulled down, so this point is also going to be pulled down. Since it is being pulled down in, you know, what you call this, counterclockwise, the rope is going to rotate in counter, I mean the pulley is going to rotate counterclockwise, right? And this point is, will be pulled up, right? And coming back, so this is actually connected to here. So this is going to be pulled up. So since this is pulled up, any point here or here is going to turn in this direction, which is clockwise direction, right? Let me draw here. And since this is moving here, which means any point here is going to be pulled to the right, let's say, which means the arrow direction should be here. Since the rope is moving in this direction, which means the pulley is actually going in this, let me draw inside, in this direction, okay? And since this is moving in this direction, which means the rope point here is moving in this direction, which is true with this one. Since any point here is being pulled here, which means the rope is actually moving to the, let's say, clockwise direction, right? So since this is, let's say, this point is being pulled here, so the same happens with this point, which will be pulled to this direction, right? And I hope you are getting even that fast. So since this is moving down, so the point here will also move down, okay? And since this point is moving down, which means the rope here should be pulled in this direction, which is this way, which is counterclockwise. Yeah, so as you can see in everything, though the head will follow the tail, that's what you can cross check. So since this is going down, so the rope here is actually pulled in this direction, which is going to be this direction, okay? And which is through with this point, because it has to be pulled to the left. And because it's being pulled to the left, which means the pulley has to rotate in this direction, okay? And because this is being pulled up, so we finally have to pull this up, okay? Which is not required for us, but just for understanding, I have drawn. So this is how the pulley, I mean, if I pull this weight, the whole rope will move. This is how what you should understand. But in as a quick note, we can sort it, like you just have to, you know. So this is, say, in this, right? So I will do one thing. Right now the smallest pulley is this one, right? So this and this direction is actually, what is this, clockwise, right? This is going to be clockwise. So whatever pulley is moving in a clockwise direction, I will just put as plus, and the other clock, the whatever pulley is moving in anti-clockwise, we can either put it as minus or let's just leave it blank. So let me just put plus for the pulleys which are actually moving in a clockwise direction. So this is anti-clockwise. No. Okay, let me zoom in. Remote. Yeah, this is anti-clockwise. We don't need. This is clockwise. Yes, this is anti-clockwise. I will go from left to right. Left to right. I will go, try to check like this. Something like, let's say, I will try to check. I know. I mean, I will try to identify the pulleys. Something like this. Okay. As you can see now. So yeah, let me get back. So this is anti-clockwise, which is not required. This is clockwise. I have put plus here. This is anti-clockwise. I won't put anything here. This is anti-clockwise. No. This is anti-clockwise. No. This is clockwise. Yes, plus. This is clockwise. I'll put plus here. This is again clockwise. I'll put plus here. This is clockwise. I'll put plus here. This is anti-clockwise. I won't put anything. This is anti-clockwise. I won't put anything. This is going to be anti-clockwise. No. This is clockwise plus. Okay. So let me come here. This is again clockwise plus. This is actually, yes, clockwise. I'll put plus. This is anti-clockwise. No. This is turning this way, which is anti-clockwise. No. This is turning this way, which is clockwise. I'll put S. This is turning this way, which is clockwise. Put S. This is turning this way, which is anti-clock. No. This is turning this way, which is anti-clock. No. This also anti-clock. No. This is turning this way, clock. Yes, plus. This is again anti-clock. No. So the total plus I have already is 1, 2, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, right? So you can just count. So totally, 11 pulleys are being turning in clockwise. I mean the direction in which the smallest pulley is turning. That's what the question wants. You know, smallest pulley will rotate in the same direction. So that's the question. So the other thing, like if you just count all the pulleys, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So we have 23 plus overall. So the remaining rest, which is going to be 12. So 12 pulleys is actually, so 12 pulleys is actually turning anti-clock. So that's what you want to note, right? So that's it. I think the explanation is easier. Or if any kind of such kind of questions has been given, I hope you will be able to solve. And practicing such questions, some taking some samples and batting these will help you speed up the process of doing this. And let me do that actually. Let me show how I will, you know, instead of drawing all these marks, how I will actually, okay. So this is how I will be turning it. So this is turning this way. Okay, as usual, let's say anti-clock, I will choose to put plus or minus, let's say. Clockwise, I will put plus, okay. So that's the notation I will be following. So this is turning this way, anti-clock, right? Yes, anti-clock minus. Okay, this is turning this way, okay, which is plus. This is turning this way, which is plus. Okay, I will go back here. This is actually pulling here, so which is this way minus. So this is pulled, which means this is turning this way plus. Now this is pulled, which is this way minus. This is being pulled up, right? Which means it is going this way, which is clock, right? So this is going down, so this is, which means this is turning minus. So this is going this way, which means this is being pulled up, which means this is plus. So this is going up, so which means this rope is going actually this way, which is plus. Okay, so this is pulled, which means this is turning this way. So this is anti-clock minus. So this is going up, so this whole thing is turning this way, so plus. This is turning this way, which means this pulley is going to rotate in this way, which is minus. So this is being pulled, which means the pulley is going to turn this way, which is minus. This is being pulled, which means the pulley is going to turn this way, which is plus. This is being pulled, which means the pulley is turning this way, which is anti-clock minus. Okay, and this is being pulled down, which means the rope is pulled down, so this is minus. Here it is pulled up, so this will be turning in this way, which is actually plus. So here also it is pulled down, so this is actually turning in this way, which is plus. And because this is being pulled up, and so the pulley will move in this direction, which is again plus. And because it is being pulled here, so the whole thing will rotate in this direction, which is minus. So this will also rotate in this anticlockwise, which is minus. This is also rotating in anti-clock minus. That's it. So that's how I will mark this is it. So I hope you got this. So let's quickly move to the next question. All right, let's see what they want. Let me erase this workouts. Okay. So the question says, which option will replace the question mark? Okay. So they have given three patterns here. 1, 2, 3. So I have to identify the fourth pattern. That's the question. So let's see how we can go. There are four different colors. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what is happening, the number of circles are seeming to be same, and the pattern, outer pattern, like the number of outer, the first thing I will do is, what, whenever I see this kind of question, I will just check the outer pattern. Like if say I have four balls here, and how they are arranged, here it is to the front, here it is to little to the back. So I keep this, I observe this pattern, okay, I will check the other option next, especially the next one, how if it is following the same thing or not. So here, thankfully, in the next two options also, it is following the same pattern, like four bars here, and this is to the products. So my first check is done. So I don't have to worry. In this option also, I will assume that it is going to be the same one. In all the options, fortunately, it is same. But in case in the option misses, you have to first identify the outer pattern. Now we'll move through the colors. So as usual, I usually go either row wise or column wise, but here it sounds that going row wise seems feasible. So let me check here. Sorry, here as I was observing, so there is one blank ball, green ball, black ball, orange, what is this? Brown ball, let's say. The same is actually repeated here. Blank, green, blank, brown, which is same here also. Blank, green, blank, brown. So it is sure that in the fourth one also, the first row is going to be same. Okay. So in all the, this is looking different, right? So you can see the blank is not in the first one, which is what we need here. So straight away, I will eliminate this one, this option. Okay, which is easier, right? Now let me see here. There are something happening in the third row also. Some colors are changing. The fourth row, yes, again colors are changing. But I observe one thing here. What I observed is, if you observe this green particular green bar, so it is actually being in the same position in all the three options, right? Similarly, the brown ball here, what I observed is here, is actually being repeated in all the other options. So which is good. Like, let me check in the options. So we want green and the brown to the right. So which is available here, available here, available here. Fine, no problem. Okay, so that clears. We are unfortunate that we could not eliminate any option, but let's move. So what is happening now? So I will tell. So this color ball, this color ball, we don't have to worry anymore, right? So we are not concerned anymore about these particular balls because they have been clear now. So the only thing we have to check, even if I am observing, this yellow ball is also being repeated in all the options, right? So let me also check that. So yellow is here, here, here. Fine. So let me just ignore in my analysis. Let me just ignore this. So I'm just drawing all this. In exam, I won't be doing this. I will, visually doing this, but explanation purpose, I'm doing this. Okay. So I hope you understand that. So let's see. So we are only left with three colored balls. Two are cyan and one yellow. Let's see if the colors are being changed. No. Two are cyan and one yellow. Two are cyan and one yellow, right? So what is happening? Here, the cyan is here, and one more is here, and here is a blank here, okay. And one yellow is tailing the cyan. Now it's tailing the cyan. Okay, cool. So what I understood is, if you see this particular, let's say I call this 1, 2, 3, okay, different color if you want. Okay, 1, 2, 3. The three, yellow three is actually tailing two, right? So if you see here, let's say if this is my two, this is three, and this whole thing has moved to, let's say, one step in this direction. Okay. So in the next one, in the next pattern, the third one, the two has moved to one step to the right. Likewise, three has moved to one step to the right. So they are actually tailing, which is good. And the one, if I, relate with this, what is happening? So we have one blank here and one. So after two, so I can see one black here and one. So let me check here. After two, One is here. So I have one blank here and one. So actually what is happening, what I understood is, it is clear to me that take this color. You know, this whole thing is actually trying to rotate in this direction in one step, each in each pattern. This whole thing, right? This now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 balls are actually trying to rotate. Is that yeah, in one step. Okay, so that's what I understood, because you can see here 1 empty space 2 3, 1 empty space 2 3, one step more, further 1 step 1 empty space 2 3. So following this same logic, you know, if I draw those 6 balls, you know, 2 on the top, further 2 on the extreme and 2 on the bottom, okay. So 1 is here, so in the next step 1 should be here, let me put it here, this should be my 1, 7, right. It should be followed by 1 empty space, so let me put this empty, and 2 should be on the other one, this should be 2. And 2 should be tailed by 3. So this is going to be 3. Since okay, blue, yellow is good. So I hope you understood this logic. So let me check the options. Okay, so we need 1 here, which is visible here as well as here. So straight away, A disqualified, got disqualified. And we need to have one empty space here, one empty ball here. I mean, here I can see, here I can't see. So straight away I have to disqualify this. So only B got qualified, which is again okay. So that's it. I hope you understood the logic, right? So let's move to this next one. So let me erase all this stuff. I'm assuming that the explanations are helping you, the videos that whatever I'm making you are helping you solve other kind of questions also. So question says, shown below is a map of the city with names of prominent localities. Okay, a man starts walking from Hampalkatte, right? What is that? Hampalkatte, probably a Karnataka language, Kannada one, because I know those, you know, I have visited those places. Okay, from Hampalkatte towards the west, okay, takes the second right, second left, first right, third right, second right, straight on, straight to the end of the street. Where does he reach? Okay, the question is, so given the person starts from here and moves to what is that, west, which means, so let me draw here. I have already explained this directions and all, so I just want to revise here, that's why I have taken this question. North, this is north, is going to be south, east and west, just remember this. Okay, so the person is actually moving, you know, to the west, which means he has started and moved in this way, the person from Hampalkatte, right? So and have taken this particular directions. Let me write down here for easy understanding, or something here from here, right? Okay, let me write it down here. It's not required, but still takes second right. I'm just writing down here, because this is too small to view, for you to view. I'm just putting down here second right, then second left, let me put L, and first left, okay, third right, second left, okay, 2L, and walks straight up to the end, then let's say straight. Okay, so this is how he is moving. This is simple question, I know. I just want to revise whatever we have. Oops. or discuss in the past video on what is that? Divergences. Okay. Fine. So let's go from here. Let's start from here. Okay. So since here the person is starting from here, let's say P. He takes second right. Right. So if he's starting, the person is actually facing these two big, I guess. Okay, the person is actually like this. So he is facing this direction, right? So his right is actually this, and his left is going to be this, right? It is clear, right? So the second right, the first one is second right, which is, so this is going to be the first right, and you know, this is going to be the second right. So the person will actually move up to here. Okay, clear? This color, sorry. Okay, he has gone up to here. So this is done, and he has taken second left. So he is still facing west, which means in this direction. So his left is going to be this. Okay. One second. Yeah, he has taken right. Sorry, one second. I need to be clear. So from here, he has taken second right, which means he has turned it this way, right? So this is going to be his first right, and this is going to be second right. So after coming, reaching here, he has taken right, which means he has not, right now he is not in this direction, but he is actually facing, how to rotate this? No. This way. So he is right now standing and facing this way, you can assume, right? So which means now his second left is going to be so this is going to be the first left, and this is going to be second left, right? So which means he has gone till here, and he has taken left. So which he has taken left means he has turned in this direction now, right? So again, we have to turn this guy for explanation. 90 degrees to the left. Okay, so now he is facing this way. Okay, now what is saying? He takes one left. Left is to the down, which means he has come here and he has turned this way. So now he is facing this direction, right? So let me turn the guy here, the robot, let's say the robot. I have to rotate to left again. Yes, so he is facing in this direction now because he is down. And what they are saying, he has taken the third right, right? So from here, you know, his right is going to be this. So this is going to be the first right, second right, third right. So which means, so he has come all down here, and he has taken right, which means he has turned in this direction. Now I have to turn this robot or guy again. Okay, so now he is facing like this. You are getting right, I hope you are getting. So now from here, what he is doing? So this is done, this is done, this is done. So he has gone to left, he has taken the second left. So now the left is actually the bottom one, so the first and the second. So this is going to the second left, and he has turned, so which is in this direction. Okay, and then he has taken the straight path. Okay, let me turn it. Am I missing something? Why I'm ending here, which means I have done something wrong. Let's see. No, second left, first left, yeah, third left, first, second, third, okay. Second left. So here is this one. Okay, and he's going straight at one side, second left, and walks on straight to the end of the street. Okay. I don't know. I think I'm missing something. Let's check here. Sorry, guys. Let's see. Below is a map of city with the name of prominent localities. A man starts walking from Hampalkatte towards the west. Okay, he has started from here, and west is this direction. He is going this way. Okay. Takes a second right. Okay, from here this is first right, and this is second right. Okay, he has taken right here. This is correct. The second left. So from here, if I take a second right, the left is going to be this way. The second left is this, which is this is also correct. And the first left. So if I'm moving in this direction, the left is going to be this. First left is this, which is again correct. And third right. Okay, so this is my first right, second right, third right. Okay, I have turned this way, which is correct. And the second left. This is okay. 1 second. Cool. I got the mistake. So actually, the mistake that I have done is, so from here I have to take two left right, but this is only first left. Sorry. I think you must have figured out already, but probably I was stuck in. So this is actually the first left. So I should actually take the second left, which is here, right? So from here, if I go straight, which is somewhere here, cool. So I will end up here, continually, whatever it is. So yeah, the mistake I did is instead of taking two left, which should be here, I have turned here, which is why I have got confused. So I should take left here, and straight to this is going to be Kandivali, whatever it is here. Yeah. Okay. Cool. So let's move to the next question. And sorry for the delay. All right. Again, rotation question. I will ensure that I will not take this question from next. We have enough discussion of this already. Okay. The question says, which option will replace the question mark? Good. So they have given four options here. The fifth one we have to identify. Let's see what is happening. The first thing what I do for such questions, as I already told in the previous question, that I will check the outer line, how they are oriented, and then go to the inners. So let's say if I take the inners, probably it will consume more time to solve this question. Let's say if I take 8, I will not be sure how which to correlate in the next one. Okay, how to correlate to the next one. So that is going to be painful, because if you see, we are not sure what happened to this particular, let's say, 8 in the second pattern, right? So because 8 is not visible here, which means something is going on. So we cannot go that way. That's what I wanted to say. 1 second. Okay. So what usually I do is I just ignore the inners first, and I'll take the outer, just like I have done for this question. This particular question, I have ignored the colors initially. I have taken the outer from. Likewise, I will do the same thing here. Okay, so let me check what is happening here. Okay, so the first one, what I observed for this pattern is, So there's a triangle, the bigger triangle, which is this one. And to this, one smaller triangle got attached. So that's what I kind of observed. Let's say blue. So this smaller triangle got attached, something like this. So what is happening here? Okay, it has turned to, if you see the red portion, I can see This has the red portion. Okay, and the blue triangle here attached here is here, which means this thing, this whole thing has rotated to this in a clockwise direction to say 90 degrees, right? Just 100 to 90 degrees. But here, if I see, the red is actually in this direction, which is quite opposite of this one. Okay, which means the rotation is actually going to be 180, sorry, from this to this is going to be, you know, you have to rotate two steps, which is going to be 180 degrees. Okay, let's say I follow this 180 degrees. And here, if I see this pattern, it is turned down. Okay, which means from here it has to turn 190, another 90, which is 270, right? Which means from this direction, from here, let's say I will draw here. Okay, so it will has to the only the red one, red part I am drawing. Okay, so initially in this position it is like this. So it has turned to this only after, you know, turning one. This is 190. This is going to be another 90 rotations from here, and another 90 rotation will end up in this particular direction, which is going to be, you know, 90 plus 90 plus 90, which is 270. Right? So yes, so this is going to be 270 degrees. So from 90, 180, 270. What is happening? Okay, so 90 plus 90, 180, 180 plus 90, 270. So likewise, let us say 270 plus 90 is going to be how much? 360, right? So from here, so it has to turn one complete rotation, 360 rotation. The logic is correct, which means the red should be facing down. Like this, right? This red, the triangle should be like this. So in options, if I see, only B has this particular phenomenon. It is facing down, right? Other options are in different. The other reds are in different directions. Okay. So probably all these options are wrong. B is correct. So that's what I understood. I hope you got this correct. Okay. Yeah, I think that's it. I will do. And you can see what I have done here. I, you know, the numbers haven't, you know, actually helped us actually, right? So we are, even if you see the after rotation, some 3 is here, but in previous one it is 9. So which is something only here it was 8. Here it was 5, here it was again 8. So like you see, like you can see, if I go by numbers, actually this is going to confuse me. It is going to, or sometimes I would say this will make me impossible to solve this question, right? So what I did is I went with the outer form initially. So that has helped me come out with the answer. So sometimes this works, I would say most of the times it will work. So start with the outer form, that's what I wanted to tell from this particular example. Start with the outer form, then go to the inners, whether it's a color or whether it's a, you know, shape or even the numbers. Okay, so that will be a wiser way of solving such questions. So that's what I would like to say in this question. Okay, so let's move to the next question. I think I have one more way of solving this. Okay, I can see one more option here. Yeah, yes, I will tell that also. What I have just as I was checking that. Okay, so I hope that whatever time, extra time you are spending is going to be helpful. So that's why I am not hesitating here. So actually, what happening? So while I was answering those questions, I came to realize that If you see, if you observe these two pattern, alternate pattern, you know what is happening. Right, this particular shape has turned to here, this one, right, which mean which is nothing but one you know 90 degrees of this direction rotation, which is anti-clockwise, right? And if I observe this one, you know, these two one, so here also if you see this particular bigger green one, okay, so it has turned to 90 degrees, okay, but in clockwise direction, which is in this direction, it has turned to in this direction, right? So if I follow this logic, so this one should follow the alternate, which is this is going to be this one, the previous pattern, and let's say the I will follow the same angle 90 degrees and the same direction 90, okay, which mean, so if I turn this to 90 degrees in this direction, which is anti-clock, what will happen? I will draw here, so this is going to be this face is going to be come to top, which is like this, and this is going to be bottom, which is like this, right? So which is actually exactly what we require. So see, the same question I can solve in different way also. So like that we can actually play with questions as you are you know practicing. I suggest you to, you know, do this kind of alternate thinking so that in exam you will be able to answer such questions very easily. So move to the next question very quickly. So the question says, two water tanks A and B of equal square base, 3 feet 3 feet, okay, are shown below. Water flows from tank A to tank B through a tube, this particular tube they mean, okay. What will be the volume of water in tank A when the water stops flowing? All right, I got this. The question here is, once again, so given this one, let me zoom in a bit. So given this question and you know this scenario, so how, I mean, what will be the volume of water left in this particular tank here? That's the question. So before that, I want to tell about one basic physics principle, which is on the fluids. So fluid has this property, okay, so if there are two containers like this connected, this is one container, this one container, and if you have fluid filled, let's say something like this initially, so what will happen is, fluid has this property that you know the levels of fluid in both the whatever the connected is going to come to the same level, which means, so this will fall down, this will rise slightly up, which means the both after this you know happening, the level of this and this fluid is going to be like this. Okay, this is a principle, this is a universal principle, I could say, science principle, which is fluids will try to occupy the same height regardless of what they are. How you can see the width of this is larger, okay, this is large and this is small, but still, you know, both the fluids will occupy the same height, okay. So because only based on the height, the pressure of the fluid here will be decided. So just remember this. So had the case, if there is a fluid of this height, then the extra quantity of fluid, this much quantity of fluid is trying to fill this other portion, so that it will balance, it will come to the same balancing height. So that's a common, principle on science which you can remember. This applies to other kind of questions also. So following the same logic, what is happening here? If you see, so I have connected this fluid because of the height of the fluid in tank A is this much, which is quite higher than the height of the fluid in tank B. So this much height is there, which means the fluid here will experience this much height pressure. Okay, we don't have to go to the details, but what I want to say is the fluid from here will be pushed down through this tube and will try to fill this chamber B. So this will keep filling. Let me take different color for differentiation. So this will keep filling on the one side at the cost of fluid getting down here. Let's say, so up to here what has happened, the fluid, let's say this much it has come down. Okay, further, since the height is still high compared to this one, so it will still keep flowing, fluid will keep flowing, and let's say it fills up to here. Okay, okay, so at the cost of liquid from here, which is, let's say it has dropped to, so the same height, right? So because the two containers are same size, same height. So let's say after some operations, I mean after the fluid fills up to here, the brim of tank B, the fluid in tank A has fallen down to this level. Okay, there is no fluid here and fluid is only to this level. Now if you see, the fluid has still, the fluid in tank A is still at some height, this difference, right? And this pressure difference is going to continue fluid flow, which means the fluid here is going to overflow. So it continues the overflow, but the level of this in tank B is going to be only this much height because of the container restrict constraints, but the fluid is going to overflow and fall down here. Okay, but since because of this height, let's say x, the fluid is going to pump due to gravity by pressure. So this will fall down until this x is going to be zero, which means the fluid in tank A should come to this brim level, which is this. Okay, now if you see the height of the fluid here and the height of the fluid in this container with respect to the ground, okay, they are actually on the same level. Until then the fluid is going down. Now after reaching this level, the fluid starts flowing because both of them have reached to the same level as said in the principle here, right? Now the flow stops. Okay, so actually we have to find the volume of this particular fluid now. So which is, if you see, let me zoom in further. So they have given 3 feet here, and I think unfortunately they haven't given the width of this container. So let's say it is 3 again. It's a square, so let's say 3. So this is 3, and which is going to be, let's say this is L. This is length. So length is 3. Width is, which is not given, container is going to be 3. The height is going to be this much, right? So, and this height is actually 2.5. But here's the mistake, because it is starting from actually 1, not from 0, right? So from here, the scale is starting from here, the scale is here itself is 1 feet, okay? So which means the 2.5 here is not actually 2.5, it's going to be, height is going to be 2.5 minus 1 feet, which is 1.5 feet, right? You got this right. So this is just 1.5 feet. So now the volume of the fluid contained is, volume of a cube is going to be length into breadth into height, width or breadth into height. So length is 3 into 3 into 1.5. So which is going to be 9 into 1.5, is 45, 9, 13.5. So this is the answer, the volume of fluid. Right? I hope you got this concept. It's very fundamental concept, but you need to understand. I hope this is interesting to you as well. Let's move to the next question, which is similar. Okay, I need to plug in the charger. Okay, let me put this here. Let us use this. Sorry. Let me put this for reference. Just a second, I will have to plug in the charger. A sip of water. All right, so let's get back. So here they have given these containers. Let's see what they wanted us to do. P shows a basic schematic of how an air mesh works. This is P. Okay. In the opposite, in the options, the green sections are sealed. These green sections are all sealed. Fine. Of these options, which of the design concepts of an air mesh will work continuously until the liquid in the container is exhausted up to the dotted line? So this is the dotted line. The question is given this option and given the principle. So if we operate the spray continuously by this principle, which of these options will get exhausted continuously? Okay, that's the question. The question is exhaust to the dotted line. So we have to specify this up to the dotted line, it should happen. That's the question. Okay, so let me tell the basic what is happening here. Air spray, what happens? So again, physics is involved. What is happening here? So if you blow air here, you know, let me take the color blue. If you blow air here, you know, as soon as the air comes out of this nozzle, it is going to expand as like they have shown here. So which means it is going to move with some velocity, speed. You know, if you from using mouth, if you use your mouth to, you know, blow air, you can see the air coming out is with some, you know, velocity, right? With some high speed, which means if you put your hand opposing this, you can feel that flow of air as if the it is coming out from a fan, right? So what is happening is the basic principle is if some air is coming out of nozzle, the velocity is going to, velocity is nothing but speed, which is nothing but the flow of air is going to increase. And there is another principle in physics, which is velocity and pressure are, you know, inversely related, which means if velocity is going up, your pressure will fall down. Okay, so this is a principle of physics. So if the velocity is going up, pressure is going to fall down, which means, so since the flow, the air is coming out from the nozzle at a very high speed, since the velocity is going up, the pressure at this particular location is falling down. That is what you need to understand. Okay, the pressure, since the pressure is falling down, and you know, this is open, right? So this container is open, which means whatever the pressure here, the atmospheric pressure, the air which we face every now and then, the whatever the pressure we are experiencing right now is actually happening here also on the whole surface of this container, right? Now because the pressure here is dropped, so this pressure will be which is atmospheric pressure is actually higher than this pressure, this pressure here. And so what happens, let me take different color. So this pressure is tries to push it down, push down this fluid. Okay, so and hence, since the fluid has nowhere to escape other than this particular tube, so the fluid here is going to rise up, and you know, it will come here, and it will get carried by this blowing air as particles. Okay, as particles, and that's how the spray will happen. You are getting this right? So the logic is simple. So if you are blowing air, velocity is increasing. Because velocity is increasing, pressure will decrease, because velocity and the pressure are inversely related. This is how in maths we show, in physics we show. Because this is pressure is decreased, has decreased here, the other pressure, which is atmospheric pressure here, is actually trying to push it, push the fluid here. The pushed fluid has no other way other than filling this tube, coming out of this tube. And the fluid that has just came out of this tube is going to get carried away by this blowing air as small particles, which will appear as the spray, right? So that's a basic logic that you should understand. Let's get to the question options. So remember the important thing. These are actually sealed, means the the air inside these tubes are actually not free to atmospheric pressure. That's what we need to understand. Okay, now all the seals, just ignore the tubes here, assume, because assume only one way, just ignore this. Let's say this is our sealed, the air inside are sealed, are not affected by atmosphere. That is one thing you need to understand, just because these things are sealed. Okay, I hope you got this. So remember that point. Let's move to this option. So in option one, if you see, okay, can I zoom in better? No. Okay, let me take this. I want to take the maximum zoom. Fine, this is better. Okay, so green color. Okay, yeah, blue. Fine. So let's take this option. A option here. So if I blow air here, if I do the spray here, so like I already said, the pressure is here is going to reduce down, pressure is going down, right? But which means the air will be sucked from here, right? Because pressure is down here, water available air is going to come up. See, remember one thing, in nature fluid or liquid air, that could be air or water, liquids always flow from low pressure to high pressure. That is what you need to understand. If you see water, in a dam, if you see a dam, water will always flow down, right? Basic principle, right? Because at here, let's say the pressure is going to be different, and this pressure difference is because of freeness, it is going down, it is going to pull. And that's why if you even see the overhead tanks for water, if you see the water overhead tanks which are available in villages, even in cities and all, they are raised because they have put the water to some height, this much height to the ground surface, so that if I turn this tap here, the water will flow through the pipes and this will maintain a pressure of this much height, minimum this much height. Okay, and this pressure, because of this high pressure fluid here, and the pressure here is going to low pressure, the flow will happen from high pressure to low pressure. That's what I want to say. So which means, so fluid, any kind of fluid will always flow from high pressure to low pressure. That's what you want to understand. So likewise here, since the pressure is low here, the liquid here, there is no liquid, air is there. So the air will try to go suck, will get sucked from here and go out. Okay. Had the case, if there is no pipe here, let's say the tube is not here, this is straight pipe. So because the air gets sucked, there is nothing here. So the fluid has to be sucked also and should come up and do the spray action. Okay. But that is not the case here. Okay. You see, this particular tube is connected and open to atmosphere, which means the air here can go and fill that tube. So since I am sucking air from here, so the air here is getting vacated, but at the same time, because the pressure is low here, the air from outside is going to be filled here. Okay, let me take different color. Let's say this one. So the air from outside is going to fill here, and this filled air is going to be sucked again, which is going to be carried out, which means the liquid here has no role and has nothing to do. Only the air from outside is going to be sucked and pushed out. So the spray is not going to work. This is the worst spray, I can say. This is the worst kind of nature of spray. So this option is wrong. Right? I hope you got this. Let's move to the option B. Here, if I do the spray action, and as usual, I am creating a low pressure here because the velocity is high, low pressure, which means the air is trying to be sucked here. Let's say the whole air got sucked to the top, got sucked. And now this ideally this liquid should try to rise up. Okay, but what happens is actually this liquid will rise up. This tube, the other tube is actually connected to outside, but since this is being connected here, so the air here is actually acting on this particular surface. Let me draw here the red surface, because the fluid here is contact with the outer air, so the air here is actually trying to push it down. Fine. So the push, this pressure push, is actually trying to push the whole fluid here to rise up. Okay, but here what is happening, because this is open and because this is being sucked, so you have low pressure here, the fluid will try to start to rise up. Okay, and will try to do the spray action. So this is doing the spray action. So but there is one thing here that I want to tell. The spray will continue, and let's say after some time the spray, the fluid here drops to this level. Still the outer fluid, the outer air is acting at this surface, which is actually trying to push it up, and at the same time this is going to pull up, suck out. So still the sucking goes, continues, spray action continues. Only when it reaches to this particular level. Okay, what happens after this level? Let me erase font. Okay. I think I'm overdoing, but still, okay, for your understanding, I want to make you clear, make it clear. Okay, fine. So after the fluid drops down to this level, so now you see here, from here what is happening, the air from outside is connected to this pipe, which is free. So you have space for the air to escape to this path. Okay, so which means the atmospheric air from here is actually filled here, and then it is being sucked through this pipe, and the spray will happen. Spray of only air will happen, but not liquid, because liquid after this down is not getting any opportunity to be sucked. Only air from here is going sucked. The air is air is easy to be sucked, right? So it will get sucked from here. So this sucking will get continued. So the spray action will happen only up to this level, from here to here, but not to the dotted level. So unfortunately, this is not the option. That's what you want to understand. I hope this is clear, right? Let's see the option C. What is happening? So as usual, I'm spraying here. I'm putting air here. I'm creating low pressure here. which means I am sucking the air here. Now you see this pipe is connected only to here, and this has no connection between these two, which means this is actually trying to fill air the inner part, keep the inner part air to be atmospheric pressure. Whatever pressure outside is going to be here, even if the level, the fluid level is going to be lower, this emptiness, the vacuumness created is being compensated by the outside air. So yes, so if I pump air from here, if I create low pressure here, the actually this fluid, because of low pressure vacuum, let us call that as vacuum, the vacuum created is going to pull this liquid up, and the spray action is going to take place. Okay, and because of this, the liquid level here is going to drop down as the spray continues, which will increase the space here, which means the air is going to suck, but still, because this is connected to outside pressure, that is being compensated, and the sucking continues up to this wherever the opening is there, which is along this dotted line. So the spray is going to continue till the end, which is current. I hope you got this. Okay, so let's quickly move to this one. So what is happening here? This is locked, this is not connected, which means here there is vacuum. I mean, if I lower this liquid, volume is going to increase, but the air has no space to expand, and so that is called vacuum in science or physics terminology. And let us see what is happening with this. So this is connected to here, right? So which means, like as I told, the air pressure from outside is acting on this particular surface. Let me put it black. So this is actually trying to push the fluid. Okay, so even if I, let's say, spray air and create low pressure, try to suck the air here and try to suck the fluid from here, and because this fluid is being sucked, the fluid here has to go up, which means the fluid level here is going down, and which is creating larger opening here, which means vacuum is being created, which the vacuum prevents the flow of fluid. But because this is connected here, which is actually trying to push it, so this two will be compensated, which means this this pushed fluid will try to balance here. Okay, so this will continue, and let's say if the level goes up to here also, where this is just ending, still, if you see, this is actually not connected to this pipe, this tube is not connected to this tube, this is open, so the air from here is actually trying to fill inside, which will help in pushing the fluid down further. Okay, and the spray here is just connected to until this end, right? So the sucking action will continue until this bottom, right? So I hope you got this also. So actually, this also got. That's it. I think it's already late. I have two questions. Okay, let me solve this in the next videos. But whatever discussion we had in this video, I hope it was helpful for you all. Fine. Okay, alright, let's catch up in the next video. Thanks for watching. I hope you are getting some helpful information from these videos. Bye bye.